Hello everyone and welcome to a new video. MC Mora here, and in today's video we are diving deep into the hot waters because we are gonna be comparing the Street Fighter 4 and Street Fighter 5 comeback mechanics. These are obviously the ultra combos and the V triggers respectively. Now I know that when we compare Street Fighter 4 to Street Fighter 5, many of the audience will straight out dismiss Street Fighter 5, and some will say that the ultra combos from Street Fighter 4 were just super moves, right? So they were not very snowballing in nature. But I think this is a very shallow way of actually addressing the matter. So let's start first with Street Fighter 4. In Street Fighter 4, each character had two different gauges to manage. You had the Super Gauge and the Revenge Gauge. The Super Gauge is pretty much standard, right? This is the same as Street Fighter 5. One attack will just use EX Gauge, or you can use an EX attack with one bar. And if you have the whole thing, you can cash in for a super combo or a critical art. Now, the Revenge Gauge or the Ultra Combo is the circular one. And when it is above 50%, you get to use your Ultra Combo. For example, here is Cammy's Ultra Combo 1. Notice that the attacks are pretty similar, although the Ultra Combos do a lot more damage overall. Now, one thing to consider here is how you get to build the Revenge Gauge and what you get to spend it on. So here we are gonna go back to not having a Revenge Gauge. Notice that now it's completely empty. To build the Revenge Gauge, you have to pretty much tank damage. You have to eat hits or lose HP. That is the only way, and there is no other way to build your Revenge Gauge. Now, this could be ship damage, right? If I'm blocking fireballs like that, I am getting to increase my Revenge Gauge. If I get straight out hits, it will increase. Or even if I take wild damage, this is through, for example, absorbing fireballs with focus, this is recoverable damage, I still get to increase my Revenge Gauge. When it gets to 50% or above, I will have access to my Ultra Combo. Now, one of the really cool things about Ultras is that depending on how full the bar is, the Ultra Combo damage will increase. So for example, here with Cammy, if I use the Ultra Combo at 50%, it's gonna do less damage than it did when it was at 100%, right? Notice it did almost substantially less damage. So that is interesting. Now, one of the things that you should note is that you can't really use the Revenge Gauge on anything else. For example, in Street Fighter 5, you can use your V Gauge on V reversals. You can use them on B-shifts. In Street Fighter 5, you only use the Revenge Gauge on Ultra Combos, and that is pretty much it. And this is actually one of the really interesting things about this mechanic. Usually, a lot of players, especially of the old school players, they will tell you that Street Fighter 4, the supers had a lot of utility, while in Street Fighter 5, the supers are just combo enders. And I think there is something to be said there, but I also have my own theory on why that is the case. Let's take a look at Ryu throwing fireballs, right? You can use one EX spiral arrow to go through that, right? And obviously with the EX gauge, you also have access to the EX dive kick. You have access to a 4 EX attacks, you have FADC. You have a lot of resources that you can spend, and lot of utility with the full bar of the EX gauge. Now you can use that entire EX gauge for a super move, and that super move will go through the fireball. This is pretty much the same as using Cammy's critical art to punish a fireball, right? However, you can also use the ultra combo, right? And that's where the utility aspect comes into the play. Notice that in Street Fighter 5 or even in Street Fighter 4, if I am spending my entire EX gauge just to punish a fireball, I am pretty much giving up the options to use EX dive kick, EX spiral arrow, EX DB. I am losing all of these options just to punish the one fireball. While in Ultra Street Fighter 4, I can't really use the Revenge Gauge on anything else. I just have my Ultra Combo, right? It's not like I can spend the gauge on EXs or anything like that. So when the neutral opportunity comes up, I have the option to just punish it pretty much for free, right? When I do the Ultra Combo to punish the Fireball, this is pretty much free damage, right? I'm not really, there isn't really judgment, there isn't a player choice here, right? I'm not gonna choose, should I use my EX bar here or not? There is no choice. And that's why they have a ton more utility in the neutral. Now, one other thing that I also have to mention is because there is no choice, they are a lot more prevalent. Remember that your opponent will have the ultra combo pretty much every round. You can't bait it, right? They don't have to give up anything to build up the ultra combo. And this is one of the more interesting aspects. For example, in Street Fighter V, a character who don't have a defensive option will need to spend their V gauge to V reversal or to V shift. There is really nothing of the sort in Street Fighter 4, right? They will get the ultra gauge regardless. Cammy will have access to her ultra combo every single round. And every single round, once the gauge is flashing, she can simply use up the ultra gauge to go through your fireball. You pretty much have to worry about this every single round. There is no way to play around it. Right, you have to simply play around the ultra itself, but you can't play around the fact of denying her the ability to get to that ultra. So while I do think that the ultra combos were a lot more tame of a comeback mechanic, I also think they were a lot more limited of a comeback mechanic. I think it's very boring as a comeback mechanic because the way you build it is passive for the most part. You can't really spend the gauge on anything else, and you can deny the opponent the ability to build the gauge, right? So there is no way to actually counterplay. There is no way to actively counterplay the mechanic. You can counterplay the actual ultra by not throwing fireballs, but you have to deal with it, right? You can't like force them to use V reversal or bait V shifts and anything of the sort. So let's now talk about the V-Triggers in Street Fighter V. V-Triggers is the comeback mechanic in this game, and V-Triggers itself is very different from character to character. It's not like a super move like the Ultras from Street Fighter 4. Here each V-Trigger is unique to each character and they differ a lot in what they offer. For example, Chun-Li's V-Trigger 1, it's an install, it's a power-up V-Trigger, it pretty much buffs her frame data on hit, gives her access to a couple of new properties and all of that. She also has another V-Trigger, and this one is Zaki Kosho. It gives her access to a new special move, which again is obviously Zaki Kosho. Gives her some new combo routes, some, you know, interesting sequences on block. So both of them are completely different, and even they are different in how much V-gauge they require you to activate. So that is pretty interesting. So the functionality of each of the V-Triggers is actually different, you know, across the board. Now let's talk about how you actually get to build your V-gauge and how else can you spend it, right? Because it is an important part of the mechanic. Building and making a choice as a player is an important part of how interesting the mechanic is. Now in Street Fighter V in general, you can build your V-gauge through three different ways. The first one is obviously just like Street Fighter 4, by getting hit. If you are getting hit by the opponent, you will be building your V-gauge. So that is the first way. The second way is by doing counter hit attacks. So if you happen to land crush counter attacks, they will build you V-gauge. Notice that with this standing heavy kick, because it landed as a crush counter, we were able to build some V-gauge, right? The same for the sweep and any crush counter attack in general, although the meter build on the individual crush counter is different, right? So that is important to note. The second way you can build your V-gauge is by simply using your V-skill. For example, this is Chun-Li's V-skill, it is this command jump. If you happen to hit with it, you are building your V-gauge. So you can build your V-gauge by landing crush counters, you can build your V-gauge by getting hit or by eating damage pretty much, and you can build your V-gauge by using your V-skill. So these are really interesting things. Now obviously you can combine both of these or these three elements to do a ton of weakish building, for example, with a character like Shang-Li. This is a pretty interesting combo, and you get to build a ton of weakish. Now, is there is other ways to spend that bar instead of just using the ultra combo, just like Street Fighter 4? Well, actually, yes. There are two other ways to build or to spend your V gauge. You can use it on V reversals. This is pretty much an alpha counter, a defensive option that you can use on block to push the opponent away from you. Or you can use it on the V shift, which again is kind of like a pseudo dodge mechanic. Now, this, in my opinion, is a lot more interesting than just using your bar for ultra combos, right? Because you have a choice here. For example, for this Ryu, I can maybe use my critical art and go through fireball. The neutral utility is the same, right? Shanli's critical art in Street Fighter 5, it has the same neutral utility as her Ultra 1 from Street Fighter 4, right? It's just that obviously you're gonna spend your entire critical gauge. While here, for example, you can use the V-shift as well and just push through the fireball. Obviously, you can use her V-skill as well. There are multiple ways to go through fireballs. So you have more than one way to actually spend your V-gauge, which makes it the more interesting mechanic, in my opinion. Now, usually when people talk about a mechanic being better or worse as a comeback mechanic, they usually mean how volatile it is. And V-triggers can be extremely volatile. They can lead to a ton of comeback factor. I do think this is an aspect that have gotten improved in the later seasons of Street Fighter 5. The balancing of the V-triggers is a little bit better, and they can lead to a ton of robbery. But I do think as a mechanic in general, in terms of how you get to use it, how you get to build it, is there is some really good player driven choices that have to be made. I think all of that is true for the V-trigger mechanic in Street Fighter 5. So I do think overall it is the better mechanic. It's the more interesting mechanic. Maybe the balancing could need some tuning on some of the overpowered V-triggers, but I think as a mechanic overall, it's much better, and it's a big step forward from the ultra combos in Street Fighter 4. Let me know your opinions in the comment section below. If you have enjoyed this video, please leave a like or a comment. It helps the channel so much. I will be leaving a link to the Patreon page and the Discord server page in the description below. Thank you very much for watching, and stay safe.